for inviting us and allowing us to share our results with you on this webinar series. As Steve said, Biognosys company is located in Zurich, Switzerland, and today I will show you our high-throughput MRM protein quantification using Exigent Expert microLC 200 system. A little bit about our company. We are a small company, as I said, located in Zurich, Switzerland, and we basically have two streams of products that we offer to our customers. First one is tailor-made services, where we have we do customized research projects, also designing specific MRM and PRM assays, assays of development and measurement, and also we do method transfer to our external customers. The second stream of services are products. It's actually mass spectrometry tools. We have certain kits and software. Then standardized MRM assay panels such as plasma dive and plasma deep dive. And these are MRM assay panels for human plasma. It covers about 100 proteins in human plasma, and we also do customized assay panel development. Why do we need microLC? Basically, the idea was to increase the throughput of our workflow. Most, as you guys probably know, most of the MRM measurements were done using the nanoLC. Hooked to a mass spectrometer, usually triple quads. And basically what do we need from a microLC is to see this higher throughput, to have a reasonable sensitivity, to be able to multiplex and to do robust quantification or percent of CV. So in this, in following experiments, what we did actually to we wanted to test realistic throughput of this microLC system. Can we achieve sensitivity comparable to nanoLC? Then to define the scheduling for multiplexing experiments and to determine quantification precision. Here is the microLC that we used. So this is Exigent Expert microLC 200. The picture is on the left side of this slide, and what I would like to point out, just certain parts of this LC system is that if you see that blue box, there it's actually housing for the pumps. Above that, there is this huge robotic arm where that holds the syringe. That syringe can go on the left side, as you can see these three drawers. There are actually small drawers that can hold your sample, and it's actually in a small refrigerator that it's cooled down to around 5°C. And this robotic arm reaches to your sample, gets the sample inside the syringe, and then goes in the middle to a sample loop and ejects the sample. So from the sample loop is connected next to a column, and column is connected next to the mass spectrometer. So in this, for these experiments, we used setup. We used basically Halo C18 column. It's a column provided by Exigent, and the column had 2.7 micrometer beads with 90 angstrom pore size, and it was 5 centimeter long. We kept the column at 50°C. The sample injection loop, we used 10 and 20 microliter sample injection loops. The solvent A was 0.1% formic acid in water, and solvent B was 0.1% formic acid in acetonitrile. The flow we used was around 35 microliters per minute. On lower right corner, you can see the gradient profile. So we choose to use a 5-minute gradient. Overall cycle goes around 6 minutes with the injection and everything. And basically, gradient was started with 98% of solvent A, and it went down linearly to 60% in 4.5 minutes. Then rapidly went down to 5% of solvent A 0.1 minute, and then kept until 5 minutes at this concentration of solvent A, then ramped rapidly up to 98% again of solvent A, up to 5.5 minutes. As I said, with injections, the cycle time is overall around 6 minutes. The software that we use to schedule our runs and to process the data is called SpectroDive, and that's a software that is built in-house. It's our software. You can see one small screenshot on the left, and basically the SpectroDive is a specialized software for high-throughput, fully automated MRM signal processing. It's specifically developed for high-throughput MRM signal processing and data analysis. It's plug-in system for assay panel development, automated mass spectrometric method setup, integrates with our reagent kits, and it's fully automated peak scoring quantification. It has option of customized reporting, and it's user-friendly desktop Windows application.
Sasha, I'm sorry to break in, but your voice is starting to break up. I'm not sure if you're able to change your phone line or something, but it just started to get garbled.
Okay, how about now? Is it better?
Hopefully that will be okay. Yes, we'll monitor it and let you know.
Okay, sorry about that.
Thank you.
And so, okay, so now I will show experiments that we did with this setup, and the first experiment was to monitor effect of scheduling on performance of multiplex MRM. Basically, the setup we used our IRT kit that has 11 peptides, so-called IRT peptides. They are standard peptides as an analyte. We spike that into a human plasma sample. So human plasma was a matrix in this case. We used microLC with a 5-minute gradient, and we were varying the scheduling window. In this case, window was 1.5 minute, 1 minute and half of a minute. The loading amount was around 10 micrograms, and overall MRM panel had 30 endogenous peptides, 11 IRT peptides, and decoys. Overall, we had 350 transitions. What I would like to say that we've done all these experiments using a microLC that was hooked into a TSQ Vantage mass spectrometer. First of all, before we were scheduling our experiments, we had to set the optimal cycle time of our instrument. So basically, when you do MRM experiment, you have unscheduled and scheduled MRM experiments. And usually with unscheduled, you can go with the fixed dwell time and you vary the cycle time. But when you do unscheduled, when you do scheduled MRM experiment, then you want to choose a fixed cycle time where you increase the dwell time up to maximum and to get the highest response of your mass spectrometer. Basically, we did this monitoring in this albumin human peptide from plasma, and we could notice that with 0.6 second of cycle time, we had 8 data points per peak, which is, on our opinion, good enough to quantify certain peptides very well without oversampling or having to less data points. So in all further experiments, our scheduled experiments, we use this 0.6 second cycle time. These are the results of the influence of a scheduling window on this scheduled MRM run on percent of CV. Basically, you can see that if you choose 1.5 minute scheduling window, the CV was around 15%, but going down to 1 second scheduling window and then half of a minute scheduling window, we went down to 5% and 4% of CV. Yeah, I could explain you that with in this case, this is the MRM and the XIC extracted ion chromatogram of erbitux, of one of the peptides of the erbitux that was spiked also in human plasma. And in this case, we were monitoring exact concentration of erbitux, and we had 2.2 micrograms per milliliter. And upper panel, you can see a scheduling window of 1 minute, and lower panel, you can see a scheduling window of half of a minute. Basically, if you schedule it narrower, you will have much less interference, and you will have a higher signal-to-noise ratio, and that will, of course, influence quantification precision or percent of CV, but will also influence your sensitivity. So the conclusion is that the monitoring of a pure transition simultaneously results in a longer dwell time. So that's when you use a narrow scheduling window, you get better signal-to-noise ratio, and finally you have higher sensitivity. I just would like to point out to see, you can see the lower panel, and that the peak width at the baseline is around 9 seconds. If you have a scheduling window of 30 seconds, that's really, really narrow, and you don't have a lot of room here to miss, so you really need to schedule this properly. We can achieve this using our IRT kits, and basically running our 11 IRT kits as unscheduled run, and after that using SpectroDive software automatically transfers this IRT's time to your scheduling and to your peptides of interest. You can also see on our web page, it's diagnosis.ch, you can see how you can do that using IRT peptides and just doing it recalculating and recalibrating with in an Excel spreadsheet. I'm going to move on to experiment two. So one of the advantages of microLC over the nanoLC is a loading amount that you can use of your analyte. Basically, in nano-LC, you are limited by, of course, nanoflow and nanocolumns, and here you have much wider column and much higher flows, and basically you can load much more of the sample. If you can load more of a sample, that you can increase the sensitivity of your analyte in question. We used here two experiments. One was to have a constant ratio of IRT. Of course, again, we spiked IRT peptides in a human plasma sample. And in the first case, we were looking having a constant ratio of IRT and plasma, and then just increasing the loading amount. So you increase the IRT peptides and plasma at the same time. The second experiment was to have a constant IRT amount in plasma. So basically, with an increasing amount of a sample, you will not increase the IRT amount, but just the plasma. And basically, we wanted to see what is the influence of a matrix just on our analyte. Here are the results. This is for the first case. Here I'm showing you one of the peptides, one of the IRT peptides. This is XIC. And basically just increasing the sample loading, you are increasing the signal, the peak area, but signal intensity increases until a certain amount where it starts to plateau. So we could see that it starts around 40 micrograms of loading sample. So here is a better picture. We plotted here four of our IRTs that we were monitoring, and basically up to 40 micrograms, there is a sense to increase the loading amount of a sample. Above 40 micrograms, there was not sense to increase because it's not increasing your signal and response. The second experiment was to have a constant amount of IRTs, but to increase the matrix, background matrix, and see what is the influence of matrix increase. And basically, you can see again that at 5 micrograms, 10 and 20, the signal was constant, and then at 40 and 80 started going down. So analyze, we you want to say that in this case, analyte was suppressed with increasing loading amount of a matrix. So looks like in this case it's 40 microgram. I would say it was optimal loading amount for further experiments. So these first two experiments were done to determine specific experimental conditions of our scheduled run and to calculate LOD and LOQ of our microLC. Basically compare microLC's sensitivity to nanoLC. So in that case, we were calculating LOD and LOQ using Erbitux drug that was spiked in human plasma in different amounts. We had six samples in this case, six concentrations starting from 6.67 micrograms per milliliter down to 0.027 micrograms per milliliter. We were varying a total loading amount, 40 micrograms and 80 micrograms. And I just would like to point out that we did these measurements on a nano LC with a 30 minute gradient. That's our standard setup that we use. And we were loading 1 microgram and 4 micrograms on this nano LC. And micro LC was with a 5 minute gradient as shown before, and also with 0.6 cycle time. Mass spectrometer in this case was the same. So we did the same measurements on nano-LC and on micro-LC, and it was TSQ Vantage instrument. And I just would like to say that it's very easy to switch between these two systems. You just need to change the ionization source and do some simple rewiring, and in 10 to 15 minutes, you can switch from nano to microLC and just do the same experiment. Here are the results. Here are our LOD and LOQ values for nanoLC. On the left side, you can see the loading amount of 1 micrograms of a protein. That's our normal loading amount and half an hour gradient. And LOD and LOQ were 0.16 micrograms per milliliter and 0.29. On the right side, you can see the four times higher loading amount. It's 4 micrograms of a protein. We could notice overloading because the peaks were tailing. And basically, but in that case, LOD and LOQ also just went down. So it was instead of 0.16, so 0.075. And LOQ was 0.14 instead of 0.29. For microLC, LOD and LOQ were for optimal loading amount of 40 micrograms of a protein. That's optimal loading for this microLC, for this column actually. LODs and LOQs were very close to nanoLC, so there were 0.21 and 0.40 micrograms per milliliter. That's shown on the left side. On the right side, it's a graph where we determine LOD and LOQ when we injected, when we overloaded the column, basically injecting 80 micrograms of a protein. So as shown before, this overloading just decreases the signal, overall signal of your analyte, and that's why you're having, in this case, LOD and LOQ higher. So there is no point in using more than 40 micrograms of a protein in this measurement. This is just to give you some visual on this. These are concentrations and these are the responses of Erbitux on nano on the left side and micro on the right side for concentrations that were around LOD and LOQ. So they are 0.25 micrograms per milliliter in the upper panels and 0.74 micrograms per milliliter lower panels. For concentration lower than 0.25, you can see a bump and it's very close to background in this case. So in both cases, you can see that peaks are there, peaks are present, and this is a concentration actually around LOQ. So the results on this is sensitivity of microLC and dependence on on a scheduling window. So on the left panel, you can see a 1 minute scheduling window when we injected 40 micrograms of a protein. And on the left side is the previously shown 40 micrograms of protein where we had the scheduling window of a half of a minute. As shown again before, this the tighter the window, the better the signal. There is a less of a noise around, and that's why you are getting better LOD and LOQ. This is quantification precision that we were getting out of this microLC system. The average CV was very good, 4.3%. And that's shown on the left side. On the right side, we just plotted certain housekeepers that we always monitor when we perform these scheduled MRM runs. These housekeepers are always present, and they are peptides that you can monitor, and they should have always the same concentration, and that's basically just to make sure that your system went well, and then there was no problem with the instruments. I would like to just show you here one real case. So we had a customer that approached us with a high number of samples and a very high amount of those samples. They had a modified version of endogenous protein. The difference was one amino acid, so you cannot do ELISA on that. The MRM panel actually contained four peptides for housekeeping, three peptides of endogenous protein, one peptide was modified, and our spiked in IRT peptides for scheduling, total 45 transitions. Here you can see the XIC panel of one of those runs. The amazing thing was that we had to do 260 runs, and basically these 260 runs on microLC went through in less than 2 days. If we used nanoLC, we would need nine days to complete this task. And what was really amazing, surprised all of us, was the median CV for these 260 runs for all peptides was 1.7%. 0.6% for modified peptide and 5% for extreme hydrophilic peptides that elute very late. So my last slide would be the conclusion. I would like to share with you is that it's really easy to set up this microLC with the instruments from various vendors. I just would like to mention that Exogen did a really good job on a software that controls this microLC, that you can also set it up with other instrument vendors and other vendor software. And what I personally like is that you can control the whole microLC from the screen. So you can actually be at home, log in, and just control whole LC. You don't have to be present there on site. We achieved with the microLC much higher throughput compared to nanoLC. You could see less than 2 days compared to 9 days. We had comparable sensitivity to nanoLC. You can see here the plot where on the blue it's LOD and LOQ is in orange. And the only drawback of this microLC basically that you need a lot of sample, very large sample amount to achieve good sensitivity. Excellent CV, so quantification precision. I showed you that we did 260 MRM runs achieved in less than 2 days with median CV of 1.7%. And that's it from me. I hope you guys